Alright, hello friends, welcome to my channel. So today we're going to do a review on Yamaha MG10XU. How do we connect this audio mixing console back to your powered speakers or your stereos or your monitors or your phones and all of these things. So this video is specially focused on how to connect, but if you want in-depth review on how do we connect it to the phone, how do we connect it to a laptop, and how do we connect it to different devices, you can check out the description below. In-depth videos have been made. So today in this video we are just going to talk what are the output channels this audio mixing console provide, how do we control them, and how do we send this output through the wired cables, whether it might be balanced cables, unbalanced cables, quarter inch jack or XLR cables, whatever it might be. So we are going to discuss on that. Alright, let me zoom my camera in to the output channels here. Alright, so if you could see here, this is the entire output section for this audio mixing console, which only deals about sending your input as an output back to the respective connected devices. So we have one section called as phones, which will allow your audio signals to send it back to your phone, right? So it will take only quarter inch jack as an input cable. So we have one section, the entire section called as stereo out. So you can send your output to your stereo. So you can send it via quarter inch jack. Okay, these are quarter inch jack input cables, or you can send it via an XLR through the XLR source. So preferred one is XLR because it's an unbalanced cable and which sends audio signal pretty perfectly back to your stereo speakers. And we have one more section called as monitors, where you can send your input to monitor outputs. So you can send it via a quarter inch jack. So there is no XLR here. So for monitors, you need to use your quarter inch jacks here. And you can also send your output from a section called as FX send. You can send it to your laptop or your mobile phone or whatever device you want. But you know, it will not compromise on sending the audio signals of FX, right? What is FX? We can see that. Also, you can check out my description for in detail a review on effects, right? So how do we control them? So there is a section here where you can control your level stereo with this knob here. So level stereo is nothing but this one. This entire section, the output that is going, you can control it with this knob. You can increase the volume or decrease the volume. And how do you connect your monitor out? So you can connect it with this, whether your monitor out or your phones is controlled with this knob. And the effects that I'm speaking, which is nothing but special feature of Yamaha MG10XU, where you can change your audio signal to any of these effects, reverb hall, room, karaoke, vocal echo. Currently I'm using vocal echo. So all you need to do is press your effects on, you know, set your effects level knob, and there is a section called as effects. So currently my mic is connected here. So I have turned the knob, set the knob to 12 o'clock, right? So that's about effects. There's also one more feature. If you don't want the output to send back to your phones or monitors, you can simply click on this. This will mute your audio. So if I click this, you'll not be able to see that. You could not able to hear me because I have just pressed that button down, and my stereo, the output that is going to phones or stereo, was muted, right? So basically you can connect these devices using a quarter inch jack. If you could see, this is a quarter inch jack. I'm using a balanced cable. So basically in quarter inch jack, for male to male quarter inch jacks, you have a balanced cable where your input and output signal is supported with an underlying wire, which will help the signal to transmit pretty well from your mixer back to your power speaker. So there will be less compromise on the audio signal which will be going out to your power speaker. So I have connected my, we can also connect this using XLR cable. So stereo, currently I'm using Yamaha DBR12L powered speaker. You can check that in-depth review on my channel. So where I have connected the stereo output using an XLR cable. Here also, this is a preferred one. You can also connect it via using your quarter inch jack cables. Okay, so you, if you have two speakers, right and left, since I'm using single speaker, I've connected a single cable connected back to my speaker. If you have one more speaker, left speaker, two speakers supporting your stage show. So you can connect one more XLR cable and connect it back to your audio, you know, stereo outputs. Same thing, right, you can send one signal to your right, you can send one signal to the left. So they have mentioned which one to send it at left. So currently this is connected to left. If I have my right speaker, I will connect one more cable here and connect it to my right speaker. So it's not necessarily that you need to have two speakers. So say suppose you're doing stage conference, stage in a small hall show, or in a small church, or in a small auditorium, house purpose, one is pretty much sufficient. That too, if you go with Yamaha DBR-12 powered speaker, that is very much sufficient to blow the entire hall. And so that's about this channel. Same thing, if you have one monitor, you can send one signal to the one monitor. If you have two stage monitors, you can send it to the two stage monitors. So what if you have three speakers? What if you have four speakers? So that option would be provided to your powered speaker. If you are using Yamaha DBR-12, what you can do is that, you know, it will allow to send the audio signal from your powered speaker back to one more powered speaker. So in that way, you can connect a chain. If you're increasing the size of your powered speakers to more than two, you can send the signal not from your console, connect your right and left to your two powered speakers, and from those two powered speakers, take an output again back to any of the number of powered speakers that you wanted to connect. So that's it, friends. If you have any questions, do let me know. I'm pretty happy to assist. Thank you so much.